So there's a bunch of creators out there that are doing so much on YouTube and they're putting out so much content and they're big. They're pulling big numbers, big audiences. But it's also fascinating for me to go back to like their earlier work and I can actually see where they got to start their YouTube career. I find it so fascinating when I look at the earlier stuff and I compare to where they are at the moment and the numbers that they're pulling and the audiences and how fantastic and perfect their work is. And then you just look at the earlier work and you realize, and I actually feel so much better when I look at my own stuff. Because it was shit, it was crap, it was terrible, and they know it. So in a way, it actually makes me quite happy because what I'm busy doing, I just feel a lot better and a lot comfortable creating my YouTube channel and being creative and putting different ideas out there. I have to go through this learning curve to understand everything. I still don't have like a 100% niche or an idea that what I want to do with my YouTube channel. So I'm just literally just making content. And this is part of it. You know, even if, you know, if I vlog today and tomorrow I do like a cinematic sequence and I load that. So even if I load a cinematic sequence tomorrow on my YouTube channel, that's okay. I feel very comfortable by not following all of the guidelines that a lot of YouTube advisors give out there in terms of what you want to do with a YouTube channel, because how are we going to stand out from the crowd as far as content is concerned? You know, if I have to follow those rules to the T, it's not something that makes me happy. So there's no excuse, just go outside and create. Make whatever you feel like is necessary for you to feel happy. If you look at other people's lives, you know, they spend time replying to emails, all of the boring stuff. And your life is a lot more exciting than a lot of these so-called rich people that are supposed to be happy. The one thing though, The one thing that I do take in consideration though when it comes to creating content is that this is people's time. Like, if people are gonna watch your content, you should make it worth their while because that's their time.
Let's try this without the background noise. I don't think it was a fantastic idea for me to have gone out and record this vlog in the middle of peak time traffic. So just to summarize, if you have to take your life and compare it to an ordinary person's life, I think as a creative, our lives are a lot more interesting and we can basically convey those stories in such a way that it is entertaining to others and educational as well at the same time. I don't think that a chartered accountant would be able to convey a story in a similar fashion as a creative. So if you find yourself in a rut where you are not creating or you are waiting for the perfect conditions to create, I just want to say, there's no such thing. So you might as well just start, because you'll never be happy if you don't.
I hope that what I'm saying today actually makes sense, because I just felt that it was important for me from a creator standpoint to try and convince you to go out and to create. Do things that makes us a lot happier as human beings. If you got to this point of the video, thank you so much for watching. Please give me a thumbs up if you like this video, and if you are willing to, please consider subscribing to my channel. It does help with growth. If you resonate with what I put out, consider joining the community and let's grow together as creators. I think I'm done. Thank you for watching. Cheers.